Christmas to all of you, Tim and the fellas.
Hang on the mistletoe, I wanna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun it's going to be together. This Christmas, fireside is blazing bright.
Thank you for joining with us on our live broadcast. We appreciate you being here. I know it's been very different. Normally, you will come here on Sunday morning, get your seat, get your coffee, get yourself together for worship. But since coronavirus, we've had to change some things, and just so everyone can be safe. And so we thank you for bearing with us. We thank you for all your contributions. We thank you for your prayers. And just know that God is going to bring us back together again. I know it's been a lot with the coronavirus, the Black Lives Matter movement, and also who's going to be the next president of the United States. But just know that the same God that we served before we went into this pandemic is the same God that's going to bring us out. Hey, if you want to contribute to the House of Faith Ministries, please go through Cash App, $GiveWithFaith. Or you can go through PayPal by searching our email address, houseoffaithblvd@gmail.com. Whatever you can do to give to this ministry, every bit of it counts and helps. I also want to give a special shout out to our music ministry team for allowing this thing and this experience to happen in the virtual worship room. Look forward to seeing you as you continue to watch our broadcast. God's got a word for you.
Welcome me. and I will be there.
Even as it is in.
Hey, welcome to our live stream. We thank you for joining with us. Make sure you check us out every Sunday, 10 o'clock a.m. on the dot. Look forward to seeing you here in the place. God bless you.
I had to stand on the shore and watch Zion's ships go sailing over. I stood on the banks of Jordan. Oh yeah, I have
seen those ships sailing over.
Oh, oh, oh. I stood right there on the banks of Jordan, and my father, and I
And so I'm excited to celebrate with you on tonight. and let you know that the joy of the Lord is your strength. And you can stay up a little longer for that clock to hit 12. And we're going to go on over. But we're going to go into a word of prayer and a little bit of praise and worship to lead us into our watch night service on tonight. So, Father, it's in the name of Jesus. We come to you thanking you that we have the opportunity to celebrate 2021. God, we thank you that you kept our lives. You kept us from hurt, harm, and danger, seen and unseen, God. You sent your angels to stand around us and encamp us to make sure that the enemy didn't come in and destroy us. You said when the enemy comes in like a flood, you will lift up a standard. Thank you for keeping the standard lifted because I'm still alive. You gave me breath in my body one more time. And so I just want to tell you thank you, God, for doing a miracle again. Hallelujah. I want to tell you thank you because I have the activity of my limbs. Hallelujah. I just want to tell you thank you, God, because you never fail. And you ain't going to start with me. Hallelujah. And as long as we're on your side, we will never be defeated. So we thank you for the victory on this year. Yeah, we had some trials. We had some tribulations. But we still have the victory. Hallelujah. We still have the victory. And so, Father, we give you the glory. We give you the honor. We give you the praise. In the name of Jesus, we pray. We thank you. We worship you. And we say amen. We ask that you would like and share this program so that someone else may be blessed, not just you, but your family, your friends. Let them feel the glory of the Lord through this live on tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands with us. Yeah. Have your way, Holy Ghost. We welcome you tonight.
Say, I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the Lord.
He is worthy to be
praised.
For
He is worthy to be praised.
I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the Lord. For He is worthy to be praised.
I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the
For
Lord.
He is worthy to be
For
praised.
He is worthy.
You know the Lord liveth.
And blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth. And blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted.
Oh, you know the Lord.
Blessed be the rock.
blessed be His all.
Oh, blessed,
blessed be the rock.
So glad I made it.
I could have lost
lost my mind. I could have lost my mind. But I made it through.
I
wish I had a witness. Is there anybody in here that's been through anything?
So glad I made
that you almost threw in the towel. But when you look back over your life, you realize I made it. I made it.
Is there anybody in here? I made it through.
like you see me cry. It's just a sign that I'm still alive. Got some scars, but I'm still alive. In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me, and it's working for my good. Oh yeah, I said it's working for my good. Sometimes I don't understand it. It's working for my good. So glad I made it.
As we go into 2021, Father, we ask that you would lead us, that you would guide us along the way. Lord, if you are leading us, we cannot go astray. Hallelujah. So we ask, Father, that you would lead us and that you would guide us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Psalms.
Oh! Responsibilities, all of this going on, and it seems like I'm doing everything I can for you, and everything is just going opposite. Anybody ever been there where it seems like you were doing all you knew to do, and still you took two steps forward and you took five steps back, and you're saying, God, what in the world is going on? And I was sitting in my kitchen, and I didn't understand it, and then these words came. I said, Lord, you are good. You've been so good. Lord, you are good. You've been better than good. I can't praise you enough. I owe you my life. Can't praise you enough. Even if I try, 'cause you've been so good.
Lift your voice. Come on, tell them today.
You're so good to me.
Let's go right here. Everybody lift up your voice.
Lord, you are good. You've been so good.
Come on, say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good. You've been better than good. I can't praise you enough.
It's because I owe you, Jesus.
I owe you.
Somebody say, even if I tried, it wouldn't work. Even if I tried, it wouldn't work because. Come on and lift up your voices.
So good
to me. better than good to me.
Come on, y'all. It's the last night of the year. Let's come on. Let's go here. Somehow, somehow, Lord, I've got to make this journey somehow. You know Satan's on my track, trying to take me back. Lord, I've got to make this journey somehow. Somehow, somehow, Lord, I've got to make this journey somehow. You know Satan's on my track, trying to take me back. Got to make this journey somehow. One last time. Oh, somehow. Let me hear you. Somehow. Oh, I got to make this journey somehow. You know Satan's on my track, trying to take me back. Got to make this journey somehow. Oh, send it on down, Lord. Send it on down. Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. Send it on down, Lord. Send it on down. Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. We can't do nothing till you come on down. Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. We can't do nothing till you come on down. Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. Said I won't stop fighting. Said I won't stop fighting. Everybody clap those hands. Everybody clap those hands. If I die, the Lord has kept you. Come on. Yeah. Oh, I wish I had a choir here. Yeah. Listen here. Come on. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified freely forever. One day he's coming back. Glory. Everybody clap those. Start worshiping. This is the last night of the year. I need everybody to worship. They that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The Lord is doing a new thing. The Lord is about to do some great things. And everyone that's listening,
Right now, the Lord is about to do something supernatural, something you've never seen before. I need everybody to go here and just lift up your hands and start reaching, opening up your hands and start receiving the blessing of God. God's about to send a fresh anointing on this generation. God needs everybody to lock in and to be ready. Come on, worship. Come on, everybody, worship, 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 worship. Come on, God's about to shift. He's about to shift the atmosphere. Cause I'll worship and I'll praise is shifting. Shifting the atmosphere till the heavens are open. This praise is shifting, shifting, shifting the atmosphere for breakthrough and healing. Our worship is shifting, shifting, shifting the atmosphere. It's moving, it's breaking. This worship shifting the atmosphere. Come on. Every yoke is destroyed. Every chain is broken. This worship shifting the atmosphere. Come on, everybody, come on. It's moving. It's breaking. Our worship shifting the atmosphere. Come on. Till the heavens are open for breakthrough and healing. This worship shifting the atmosphere. Come on, everybody, come on. Hey, it's moving and it's breaking. Our worship shifting the atmosphere. Hey, it's moving, everybody, it's breaking. My praise shifting the atmosphere, shifting the atmosphere. Every oath will be destroyed. Every chain is broken. This worship shifting the atmosphere. I need everybody to come on, help us shift the atmosphere with the Holy Ghost. Our praise is shifting. Our praise is breaking. Is shifting. Hey, shifting the atmosphere. Shifting the atmosphere. Yeah. It's moving. Woo! It's breaking. This worship, my worship, my, oh. Mm-hmm. Set it shifting. Lord, have mercy. Set it shifting. Did you hear that? It's shifting. You hear that? It's breaking. Listen here. The chains is about to fall off. Lord, have mercy. I said the chains about to fall off. Chains of depression. Chains of hatred. It's got to fall. It's got to fall. Because my worship is for real. Oh yeah. Because my worship is for real. One last time. My worship is for real. I need everybody that's listening, everybody that's listening right now, I need everybody to say that God's about to shift. God's about to shift. Put that right there in the thread right now. God's about to shift. Come on, I need you to help a neighbor that's probably not watching no service right now. You know somebody that's probably not watching service. Go ahead and call your friend and call your neighbor. Share this live video. Come on and share it. Come on and share it. The Lord is about to do a mighty thing tonight. I feel the presence of the Lord in this place. God's about to shift some things. Tell somebody, God's about to shift some things. He's shifting things around. He's shifting things around. Listen, this is the last year, or rather the last day of the year. God has blessed us, even though we have not been able to come together in person. The Lord still finds a way for us to worship, because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. I want us to go to this text tonight. The Lord has led me to go to this text, Luke chapter 1. Luke chapter 1, verse 41. It reads this way. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb. Somebody said, leap. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. And it came to pass. Somebody said it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. The grass withers, the flowers fade away, and the word of our God shall surely stand forever. I want to preach from this thought with the help of God. The Lord gave me this message in the middle of the night. I couldn't go to sleep for some reason. It wasn't until 3 o'clock in the morning that the Lord had put this in my spirit. And I want to preach from this thought, leap for it. Leap for it. Put that right there in the message. Leap forward. Leap forward. Leap forward. Brothers and sisters, we have come down to the end of the year. This year, we can all say, has been a challenging year. Many of us have suffered loss this year. which has left us disheartened. Many of us have suffered loss of employment. Many of us have suffered loss of money, loss of homes, loss of family. We have endured sickness, and many of us have suffered death of loved ones, ones that we've had held dear and close to us, those that we have lost this year in 2020 and would never had imagined or assumed that they would not be with us in 2021. And for many of us, we are ready to kiss 2020 goodbye. Matter of fact, many of us can just say we're sick of it. We're sick of seeing people continue to die. We're sick to see what our nation has come to in terms of politics. We are sick of police brutality. And some of us may be angry with God and are battling with the fact that he has allowed so much to happen to us. And many of us feel powerless. We feel that we do not even want to think about the future because we feel that the future is out of control. We feel that there is no use of looking for a bright side, and we feel that all of the light has been snatched away. But I want to encourage somebody that's in the process between your sitting down and your getting up. For I want to speak to somebody that there is another side to your story. That there is another side to your situation. I want to encourage you to let you know that the devil wants you to feel that there's nothing left for you. Lord have mercy. However, let us not forget that we serve a God that is more than enough, and he never runs out. You just missed what I just said. I said that we serve a God that is more than enough, and he never runs out. That is the reason why, brothers and sisters, you cannot burn out in this season. Lord have mercy. You cannot burn out in this season because God wants you to continue to have the fire lit in your life. God's got a purpose for your life. God's got a plan for your life. And I want you to understand that God don't want you to rust out. He wants you to wear out. Lord have mercy. When you rust out, that means you sit still and do nothing. Y'all ain't hear me in here. I said when you rust out, that means you don't move. But when you're moving, you wear out. When you continue in the faith, you go until you can't go any longer. And I want to know, I got anybody in here that's listening right now that can say, I'm going to go until I can't go no more. I wish I had a witness in here. I got to continue to do what I can, even when I don't feel like doing it anymore. I got to continue to worship, even when I don't feel like worshiping anymore. Because they that worship him has to worship him and spirit and in truth. When you worship God, something happens to you. When you worship God, God reveals something that you've never seen before. And I need somebody in here that can say, I'm ready for God to do something I've never seen before. I need God to do something supernatural. I need God to do a 360. I need God to do a whole thing and turn it around. Tell somebody, I need him to turn it around. Lord have mercy. I want you to understand that you still got more left in you. Amen, light. I said, I want you to understand, everybody that's listening, that you still got more in you. God don't want you to give up, and he don't want you to throw in the towel. Oh, I wish this whole church was filled up right now, because I need somebody in here that's ready to receive the abundance from God, that's ready to receive the blessing eyes have not seen. Boy, you preach, ears have not heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of what we shall be like. And he walks with me and he talks with me. Tell somebody, he'll never leave you nor will he forsake you. Lord have mercy. So as we look at this text, watch me and follow me here. As we look at this text, we find that the writer Luke, who is the author, writes to Theophilus. He writes to Theophilus. And this is not the only book that Luke writes to Theophilus, but he writes two books. Somebody put it up there so everybody can follow. And said that Luke writes two books. He writes the Gospel of Luke and Acts of the Apostles. The Gospel of Luke talks about the story and the humanity of Jesus. Acts of the Apostles talks about the actions of the apostles, of what they did after Jesus ascended. Lord have mercy. Luke writes to Theophilus. Luke says here he paints a picture of the perfect man, the man who turns himself from God form to human form. Lord have mercy. Somebody ought to just shout right there to know that God can turn things that seems impossible. Lord have mercy. Luke is not an eyewitness, but he gathers information that helps his reader to understand that Jesus is the rightful heir to the throne. Have y'all been following me here? I said he's the rightful heir to the throne. We've been talking about Jesus, talking about his ancestry. All this month, tell somebody, don't you miss this, what God is getting ready to show. Luke gives proof. He confirms right here in the opening of chapter number 1 by confirming the prophecies. Lord have mercy. The prophecies of John the Baptist and the Jesus. And Luke, he confirms the prophecy that was said 700 years BC before this time in the book of Isaiah. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill brought low. The crooked places shall be made straight, and the rough places smooth. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Luke confirms 430 years before this text in the book of Malachi, chapter 3, verse 1. He says, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek will certainly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant and whom you delight. Behold, he's coming, said the Lord of hosts. Luke confirms, he says right here, he confirms what's happening, what was prophesied in the book of Malachi, chapter 4. Verse 5, 430 years before this time. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Tell somebody, it's something when God confirms. It's something when God puts a stamp on it. It's something when God's words come to pass. And I want to speak to somebody in here that's listening right now. You think God done forgot about you? No, baby, God ain't forget about you. He's just waiting to confirm what he said that he would do. God is waiting for the right time to release what he's been holding. Tell somebody, God's getting ready to release it. Come on, say it. He's getting ready to release it. The actions is confirmed, because we see through the book of Luke that there is a voice that cries in the wilderness that has a prophetic ministry and prepares the people to receive Jesus. However, before we get to this historic event where we see John and Jesus meet at the river of Jordan, there's more to the story. Tell somebody, there's more to the story. It just doesn't start right there in the water where John and Jesus meet. meet. Tell somebody there's a beginning to the story. Lord heavens, before you can get the glory, you've got to know the story. Somebody says you got to know the whole story. Because if you actually knew my story, you will understand my praise. If you knew what I have gone through, you will understand why I give them glory and honor. You see, people see Sunday morning, but they don't see things through the week. They don't see how we had to straighten up everything, how we had to get all these things together, how we had to get recordings together, how we had to try to manage money so that we can pay all of our bills. And you want to know, why do I give them praise? Every time I come to the house of God, every time you turn on Facebook, you say Pastor Scott is hollering because I got a praise on my lips, because you don't know what he's done for me, but at least I know what he's done for me. And because I know what he's done for me, I've got to give him the glory and the honor. Somebody that's listening right now has been going through the storm and the rain, has been fighting for their life, has been fighting through sickness. I need somebody right now to just lift up your hands and give God praise that you made it to the end of this year. Lord have mercy. Tell somebody he made it to the end of this year. Lord have mercy. Luke brings to our attention two significant women that God chooses to use with their permission. Lord have mercy. Yeah, I said he chooses them without their permission. How many of you know that God would choose you whether you like it or not? Lord have mercy. You know God's been calling you to do something supernatural. God's been calling you to probably preach his word. God's been calling you to be a missionary. God's been calling you to go out into the world. But you've been sitting. Tell somebody it's time for you to stop sitting. But you got to be able to leap for what God has for your life. The Bible says that the angel of the Lord speaks to Zechariah and Elizabeth and tells them that they will have a son that will help play a significant role of bringing the Messiah. Their son is John the Baptist. Mary gets the message from the angel 6 months later. That in the Bible says that the angel visits Mary and tells Mary she will bring the Messiah and tell her that her cousin is also pregnant. Lord have mercy. It is an interesting thing that God chooses two people, Lord have mercy, to be used for what seems impossible. Lord, oh Lord, I wish I had a witness here. I said God chooses two people to be used for what seems impossible. He chooses to do something extraordinary, but chooses unordinary conditions. Y'all just missed it. I said God chooses two people. Boy, preach. God chooses two people to do something extraordinary, but chooses unordinary conditions to make what seems impossible come true. But watch this. There's a blessing in all of this. See, there's a blessing of people that have been broken. See, we have to understand that God does great things, and he chooses people like us that are broken and unqualified. Lord have mercy. Tell somebody, I was broken and unqualified, but the Lord didn't stop me from receiving the blessings of God. God picks two people out of the ordinary, one barren and one that ain't been with a man yet, and he allows them to do and to take on what they didn't have to become what they need to have. If you ain't get that, rewind the button later. Verse 37 here says, for God nothing shall be impossible. It's right there in the text. Why God done did this, he's done it for Mary, he's done it for Elizabeth. Lord have mercy. So the Lord is keeping it in the family. I want to speak to somebody. If God is blessing one member of your family, baby, I just want you to know
look out. He's coming to your house next. Tell somebody that's sitting, oh, I wish y'all was in church. Somebody that's sitting on your row, your imaginary row. Matter of fact, somebody that's with you on Facebook Live, I want you to speak to them right now and say, God's about to come to you next. God's about to do something next for your life. He's about to blow your mind. All right, I feel like preaching in here. Now, in order for us to come, this to come to pass, Mary has to accept the will of God. And the Bible here says in verse 37 that Mary says, be it unto me according to thy word, which means that Mary submitted to the will of God. For many of us, nothing has happened because we won't submit to his will. Nothing has changed because we won't submit to his will. Which brings to my first point. In order for you to see something different in this coming year, you got to submit to his will. Tell somebody, submit to his will. Not your will, not your agenda, but the agenda of the Lord. Lord have mercy. So you have to be willing to submit to the purpose that God has for your life. You have to be willing to consider the cost and go through the path that he has chosen. Not many people consider the cost. See, not many people consider the cost when it means submitting to his will. You see, Mary had to go through abandonment. Lord have mercy. She had to go through abandonment from Joseph. People looked at her strange. She might have been looked at like she was crazy. But the anointing comes at a cost. Tell somebody it's coming at a cost. It's coming at a cost. The Bible says that Mary went to see her cousin and she moved with haste. She moved with haste. And you can't waste time. You've got to make haste. When she get to where she's going, Elizabeth hears the voice. And when she hears the voice of Mary, she gets excited and filled with the Holy Ghost. I need to stop back and back up a little bit. The Bible says right here in the text that she makes haste. For some of you, you've been slowing down too much, and that's why you ain't getting the blessing. You got to learn how to move with haste, because when God blesses you, see, the angel says to Mary, you are blessed in highly favor. And when you are blessed in highly favor, you can't keep it to yourself, but you got to learn how to go and share it. Tell somebody, you got to learn how to go and share it. Lord have mercy. You got to learn how to go and share it. What happens is when Elizabeth, what happened to Elizabeth that made her filled up? Elizabeth, what made her be filled up? It wasn't what was going on with Mary that made her filled up. She was filled with the Holy Ghost. In order for you to grab what's coming for you this year, you have to learn how to listen for it. I said, in order for you to grab what God's about to do for you this coming year, you got to learn to listen for it. You got to learn how to listen for the sound. Elizabeth received the blessing of the Holy Ghost because she heard the sound of Mary. You see, many people miss out on their blessing because they don't know how to listen for the sound. But when you enter into the presence of God, you should hear the noise and get excited. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul says hallelujah. The Bible says when Elizabeth hears the sound of Mary, when Elizabeth hears the sound of Mary, watch this, the baby John leaps inside of her. It's not the fact that it was Mary's voice that made the baby jump, but what was inside of Mary. Lord have mercy. She's carrying Jesus. Did you hear what I just said? I said, she's carrying Jesus. And when you carry Jesus, people can feel the presence of God. Don't you know that's what happens when you sing and people start throwing up their hands? It's not because you can sing so good, but it's because they can feel the presence of God inside of you. That's what made Elizabeth, on the inside of her, jump. It was the Holy Ghost. This is so significant, what is happening right now. And we can't miss this blessing. I want everybody to just watch this right now. This is not the only time that John and Jesus have stood in the same presence. Lord have mercy, don't miss this. I say this is not the only time that John and Jesus have stood in the same presence. They were both in their mother's womb, flowing in water. But we do know that there's another time that the both of them was in water. Tell somebody, you just missed it. Right now, they are in their mother's womb, connecting through the spirit in water. But later on, when they became adults, they were in the water again. And at the river of Jordan, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. That's what makes the difference. What makes the difference is they were in another dimension. Lord have mercy. They were in the water. Well, you remember when Jesus came to the water of Jordan. John was in the prophetic ministry. John was doing what he was supposed to do. But then when Jesus came in the water to be baptized, John looked at Jesus and became filled and said, Jesus, I can't baptize you. You baptize me. John got all caught up. Lord have mercy. But then Jesus says, John, I need you to baptize me so I can do the will of my Father. And the Bible says that when John dipped Jesus in the water, the Spirit came in like a dove. The light shined on. And that's the first time where you see God the Father and the Holy Ghost descending like a dove and his Son all present at the same time. It's right there in the text. And this is where the Lord says, this is my Son who I am well pleased. I need somebody to get this thing in here. They were together in human flesh in the water. But it is not the first time at the River of Jordan they were in the water in their mother's womb. Lord have mercy. Somebody in here are like John and Jesus. You're in the moment where you're not fully developed. Woo! Oh, Lord have mercy. I say you at the moment where you're not fully developed. You're not where you're supposed to be right now. You are in your beginning stages. But some of us, we are like caterpillars. Lord have mercy. Nobody likes caterpillars. Nobody likes insects of caterpillars. People, they really love the butterfly. But nobody looks at you when you're a caterpillar. Nobody looks at you when you're a caterpillar. They think you look ugly. They think you're not pretty enough. They think you're too furry. They think you're not that good enough because you go all slow. But oh, when the Lord turns you into a caterpillar, Lord have mercy, what they said about you doesn't matter anymore. How they talked about you doesn't matter anymore. Tell somebody that God's about to give you some wings. Lord have mercy. What is it? Fly like a butterfly, sting like a bee. God is getting ready to give you some wings. He's about to elevate you and shift you from what was keeping you down. He's about to put you in another season. He's about to put you in another dimension. Tell someone, I need the Lord to put me in another dimension. I need the Lord to shift me to something greater. Shift me to something great. And I want to tell you that even though John wasn't fully developed, that didn't stop him from leaping. Lord have mercy. I said, even though John wasn't fully developed, that didn't stop him from leaping. I need everybody in here, everybody that's online, that's getting ready, that done had a hard year of 2020. God wants me to tell you, my third and final point. Get ready to leap. Lord have mercy. God's got something stirring inside of somebody right here. You might be ugly. You might have been ugly this year. You might have had an ugly year. You may have lost some things. But this is not the time to cry about it. But this is the time to leap and jump. And that's what happened to John. John got filled up because the presence of God. And he leaped. And that same fire that was in the belly of Elizabeth got into John when he was in the water. And that's what made him jump and said, Lord, you baptize me. I need somebody to get ready for what God's about to do. I said, I need somebody to get ready for what God's about to do. God's about to do something supernatural in your life. He's about to do some things. He's about to shift it around. Tell somebody, I need the Lord to shift it around. Watch this. I know you've been waiting, thinking that 2020 is going to be the year. But you've been experiencing heartache. You've been experiencing trouble. You've been experiencing pain. You think that every preacher lied about you. You think every preacher lied to you. Talking about this was going to be a good year. Well, baby, I just want to tell you, it may not have been a good year, but it's a leap year. You just missed what I just said. Oh, it's a leap year. Lord have mercy. Tell somebody, this is leap season. God's about to get ready from 2019. You are in 20, and you're about to leap into 2021. Lord, I wish I had some stuff up in here. God's are getting ready to shift you to the next dimension. Don't stop, because we're about to shout. I said, God is getting ready. He's getting ready. He's getting ready to turn some things around. Some things that people have been waiting for. He's getting ready to turn some things around. And I might be talking to a drug addict right now, but I want you to know that God's about to get you to leap from a drug addict and start selling Jesus. God is getting ready to leap. You might be a drunk, and he's going to leap you to serve communion. You might be a trickster, but God is getting ready to leap you to be a trustee. You might be a fighter, but God is about to get you to shift and to become a prayer warrior. I need somebody to understand that in these last moments of 2020, this is letting me know that God is giving me vision to see in the 21. That's what 2020 stands for. It means clear vision. Lord have mercy. In 2020, I've learned some things. I've learned about our system. I've learned about our president. And God is opening up my eyes to let me know that there's more work to do. Is there anybody in this room that can get ready for what God is about to do? God is about to shift you to another dimension. God is about to shift you to another place that you've never seen before. I need somebody to get ready. To get ready. It means that you are uncomfortable. Lord have mercy. Thank you, preacher. To get ready for what God is about to do. You got to change your mindset. Change your attitude. Change your personality. Is there anybody in this room that can get ready for what God is getting ready to birth? God got some fire in somebody's belly, and I need you to get ready. Get ready for what he's about to do. He's about to turn some things around. Is there anybody here that's waiting for God to turn, to turn, 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 turn some things around? I'm ready for what God is about to do. Because the Bible says, they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength, shall mount up with wings as an eagle. Run, not get tired. Walk and not faint. Tell somebody, this is my coming season. This is my coming season. I can't return to where I came from. But God, He's about to shift some things in your life. So get ready for what He's about to do. Get ready, get ready. Get ready, get ready. Get ready, get ready. He's about to help you to lead into your blessing. He's about to get you ready to leap to your miracle. He's about to get you ready to leap to another valleys, to leap to other mountains. I wonder, Lord have mercy, I wonder tonight, are you ready for what God is about to do? I wonder tonight, are you ready for what God is about to do? I need everybody to grab your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, I'm ready for what God is about to leap in my life. I need everybody, 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 every preacher, every teacher, every deacon, every usher, every nurse, every missionary, every youth group, every dance ministry, every step ministry. I need somebody to get ready for what God is about to do in the house of faith. We ain't going back, we're going higher than we ever have been before. I wonder tonight, are you ready? I wonder tonight, are you ready for what God is about to do? He's about to do a new thing. A new thing. A new thing in your life. If you're ready for what He's about to do, shout like you know it, praise Him like you know it, give Him glory like you know it, and shout for your leap year. Shout for what you've been through. Shout that He's bringing you out. Oh, He's bringing you out. Oh, 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 He's bringing you out. Won't He do it? I said, won't He do it? I said, won't He do it? I know that He'll make a way. I know that He'll open doors. If you know that He will, wave your hand. If you know that He will, shall He will? Yes, He will. I said, yes, He will. Yes. Yes, He will. Yes, He will. Yes. I said, wanna do it, wanna do it. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. I need somebody to get ready for what God's about to do. I need somebody to get ready. It's time for a praise break. I said it's time for a praise break. This is your leap year. You're about to leap into 21. I need somebody to get ready. I said get ready. Track. I just want a sound. I just want a sound. I don't want no beat. I just want one sound on the count of three. I just want one sound. One sound. I need somebody to get ready for the sound. God is getting ready to sound the alarm. He's getting ready to sound the alarm. And I need you to get ready for the alarm. When you hear the sound of the alarm, that's for you to get ready to receive the blessing of God. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, shout! Something
out of the ordinary for somebody's life. He's about to shift you into another place that you wouldn't even imagine. God's about to give somebody a place of peace and restoration. The Lord is calling the house of faith into a prophetic ministry that will speak to the lives of people that thought that no one cared about them. God's is about to do something through the members of the house of faith. God's getting ready to release an anointing where we're not known as a church of gossip, as a church with gimmicks, as a church being flashy, but we will be recognized by our anointing. We will be recognized by the anointing of God that He's pouring out into this current generation. I need everybody that's listening, I don't care what age you are. You are the current generation that God is getting ready to use to make another generation. God is calling the house of faith to move like never before. He's calling us out of our comfort zone. He's calling us to do the very unusual. Unusual church. Unusual ministry. God wants us to do church different. In order for there to be a change, there must be something different in us. He's about to put new ministries in place. He's about to give us a plan to reach out to those that people have forgotten about, left behind. God's about to open some bars. He's about to open some clubs. He's about to open some jail cells. He's about to open some hospitals. Things that have people bound and trapped in. God's about to send them to the house of faith. And I need you to get ready.
Change has come over me. A wonderful change has come over me. Change.
Anybody that wants to come to Christ, anybody that wants to come to Christ, you want to change. This is the moment that you can change. You can change. Put it right there and says, I want to change. If you want to be saved, you want to join this ministry of the house of faith, you can do so. You can change. You can change your surrounding. Change your environment. Before we end, don't do that to me. Yeah, I'm trying to quit, but every time I turn around, I see the Lord doing a new thing. Every time I turn around, I see the Lord doing a new thing. All right, I'm tired. It's time to go. It's past my bedtime. It's time to go. Listen. Listen, we got to go. Listen, I want us, all of us, I want all of us to do this seed offering for this year of 21. I want us to do it in the amount of $21. I want you to claim this as your year. I want you to claim this as your year of reaping your harvest. This is the year of manifestation. This is the year that you've been waiting for God to do something different. You're tired of the same old, same old. I want you to take advantage by sowing this seed. This seed that you're about to sow into the ministry of God. This is a commitment to God that God, you and I are going to start off good. Because in order for you to finish good, you've got to start off good. In order for you to continue to be good, you've got to start right. This is the time for all of us to sow a seed of $21. To sow the seed of $21. I want everybody to get you a seed of 21. And I want you to put on the Cash App, PayPal, in your check, and I want you to call it Leap Year Offering. Leap Year Offering. Leap Year Offering. Put it as Leap. Obey me. Obey. Follow what I said. Leap Year Offering. I'm following the Spirit of God. I want you to put this, obey the will of God, the Spirit of God, put this as a leap year offering. Watch God blow your mind. Watch God do something supernatural. Let's pray. Eternal God, our Father, I thank you for what you have done. I thank you, God, for what you're doing. And I pray, God, that you will bless this seed and bless this offering. And
And I pray, Father, you will bless the household that seeds, that sows this seed. And that they will see a different year than they've ever before. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's go.
Stood on